Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, today we're traveling to space, and not just any space, outer space. Gaganyaan is India's mission to break free of the gravitational prison we call Earth and take us to the heavens, our place in the eternal firmament. The project first started in 2014, and while it has hit several roadblocks, it's now on track to put a human in space by the end of 2021. Here's how it'll work. The orbital module will hitch a ride on the back of GSLV Mark III, get into low Earth orbit, and then break free. It will orbit the Earth 16 times a day in its low Earth orbit of 400 kilometers, the same as that of the ISS, and stay up there for around a week using solar panels for energy. After that, they'll ditch the service module and solar panels and deploy de-orbital burn to slow themselves down and undergo atmospheric braking to finally land in the Arabian Sea. And presumably, there'll be parachutes at some point. After landing in the sea, they'll fend off sharks and oceanic trash until someone comes to pick them up. Since the main objective of this mission is to keep fragile bags of flesh and bone alive up in space, I'm going to answer the important questions. Like, when will they sleep? Where will they poop? And will they be able to surf the internet? Sleeping is apparently done for 8 hours, in the day-night schedule that the astronauts are accustomed to. The whole crew module is just 3.5 meters by 7 meters, so sleeping bags Velcro to the walls or floor is probably the best they'll get. But that's for space stations. If it's different for capsules, let me know. Also, they have oxygen tanks built into their suits that last for 1 hour. What are these for? For spacewalks? Because I didn't see any of this mentioned in the articles covering this. The comments are open if you have more insight into this. The capsule will hopefully have windows, presumably made with Corning Gorilla Glass 10, and hopefully motorized cameras mounted outside, so they can look into the blackness of space, and the Earth, of course. The air revitalization system is what will keep the environment comfortable for our intrepid explorers. Human beings emit heat, carbon dioxide, and water, so all those need to be kept within a narrow set of values. The exact mechanism is probably beyond the scope of this video, or my understanding. But basically, this acts as a dehumidifier and carbon scrubber. The heat and temperature management system is in a separate module. There are links in the description where you can read more about all of these components. The menu for this mission is idli sambar, upma, vegetable pulao, egg roll, and a total of 30 dishes designed specifically for this mission. Wait, ye mission pe ja rahe hai shaadi mein? The menu is designed by this organization that I didn't know existed. I don't know about you, but if I was trapped in a small confined space with two other people, I'd be subsisting entirely on idli or khichdi. Definitely not high-fiber stuff. The moong dal halwa seems to be a particularly bad idea. Why can't they go 7 days without desserts? They'll also be providing heaters so that the astronauts can have their food piping hot. Unclear at this point if the astronauts' mothers will also be sent up in another capsule to provide fresh rotis to go with the food. They'll be able to drink water and juices through special pouches, which are probably designed so that fluids don't spill out accidentally. Because having gloops of water floating around is not a great idea. In the blueprint ISRO shared, they don't seem to be actually showing a toilet as such, assuming that's not what they're sitting on. This is how it'll likely work. You'll have this tube where you switch on a fan creating suction. And then you do your business. With how I'm imagining it, it seems to be a lot safer for women than for men. For your solid waste, you'll need to carefully dock your posterior to a plate-sized structure, which will then be wrapped in a plastic bag and stored. You should place a new plastic bag once you're done, for posterity. Internet will be available. What kind of internet? Satellite internet. But it probably won't be fast enough for Netflix binges, unless Starlink hooks them up with some GBs. 4 astronauts from the IAF will train at Glavkosmos Russia in preparation for this mission. Since Russia has had human spaceflight longer than pretty much anyone else, they have the facilities required to train in zero gravity and high G-force situations. While the crew on the first mission will likely be all male, accompanying them will be Vyom Mitra, because, you know, apparently only women can be secretaries. She is an autonomous half-humanoid designed to look absolutely hideous. She's supposedly able to recognize humans and interact with them. She has only an upper body, because if we gave her legs, she might definitely run away and jump into the sea. ISRO will probably use it to test how the artificial environment inside the capsule affects the human body, and the different stresses that act upon actual humans during takeoff, landing, and once they're in space. This project is expected to generate 15,000 jobs, among which I hope there is a good website designer. Because frankly, the current design of the ISRO website is from the 90s. Look at the SpaceX website for comparison. Some strategic investment seems to be called for. Now, all that said, the Indian public seems to be somewhat divided about the issue. With the country in the middle of a slowdown, Some questions have been raised about the wisdom of spending so much money on a project that on the face of it has no tangible benefit. After all, projects like the LHC, while being in a similar situation, at least serve to expand our understanding of physics. Here's my perspective. I don't think we should abandon aspirational endeavors just because of fluctuations in the economy. India's most valuable asset is not its natural resources, its history or religions. It's the people. And if we don't have something more than online dukans, banking scams and shareable taxis to occupy their intelligence, we'll lose our talents to other countries. You can't really set a price on sparking the imaginations of young minds. Another reason is we want to develop skill sets for the future of the space industry. If India can be the most reliable country in terms of sending people up to space, safely and cost-effectively, then all the companies that are planning to develop things like space tourism, asteroid mining, etc. may flock here in the time to come. And this is just the first step. The future might bring even more exciting things, space stations and even moon bases. Surely that's a future worth investing in. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, share, subscribe and start a conversation below to get more videos like this in your recommendations. I'll see you really soon. Bye!